Pardon? Si a fini ce Is my voice audible? Yeah. So today we are going to do a case study on HSBC Bank. Okay. So the case study focuses, you must be knowing about HSBC Bank, right? What is the full form of HSBC? What is the full form? Hong Kong and Shanghai Corporation Bank Corporation, right? HSBC means Hong Kong and Shanghai Bank Corporation, right? The case study focuses on HSBC Group, which is one of the largest banking and financial services organizations in the world. It's able to develop partnerships with organizations either trading or wishing to trade overseas. So combining its local understanding of business and commercial environments with global expertise, it is able to manage the process for effective trading. Okay, so this is about international trade. Okay, the HSBC Group's international net network comprises more than 5,000 offices in 79 countries and territories operating in the Asia Pacific region, Europe, America, Middle East, and Africa. It has listings on the London, Hong Kong, and New York stock exchanges. Right? International trade is a part of everyday life. Shops, supermarkets, and 21st century lifestyle provide a vast array of goods and services. Where they come from or process by which they arrive at the marketplace are rarely considered by consumers. Even we purchase, you know, Woodland is not the brand from India, but still, you know, they have got outlets all through the world, and you know, we purchase it happily. We are not focused on where, which country it is from. We just like it, we are addicted to it, and we purchase it, right? There are so many brands, right? Right? Now, what you have to do? Just name at least 20 brands which you know about, okay, which is not from India, but still they sell, you know, some products in India, okay? And what do they sell? Okay, I'm also going to do that exercise, you also do it, okay? Okay, is it clear? Okay. Is it clear what you have to do? See, you have to write the name of 20 brands which have outlets in India and what do they sell exactly. Fine? Is it clear, Sunil? Prabhavati, Darshana? Yeah, please write it down. I am also writing it. Darshana, Raymond is an Indian brand, I guess. Think about it. Bajaj is not an Indian brand. I guess this is an Indian brand, Bajaj. Don't write about Indian brands, please. 20, please. Everyone needs to write that down. Prabha, we are doing a case study on HSBC Bank, but I've asked everyone to write the name of 20 brands which has got outlets in India, but they are from abroad. See, HSBC is a Hong Kong, it's the full form is Hong Kong and Shanghai Cooperation Bank, right? So it's also not there from India. So even Domino's is not there in India, but you know, they have outlets in India, right? So similarly, you have to write the name of 20 brands and what they sell exactly. Okay. Okay, yeah, so everyone needs to write that down. And what do they sell? Okay, fine, fine, great. So let's proceed ahead with it. Okay. Okay, international trade is a part of everyday life. Shops, supermarkets, and 21st century lifestyle provides a vast array of goods and services. This we have read, sorry. Many consumers enjoy cars made in Germany, eat French apples, wear American jeans or trainers from the Far East, and watch Hollywood blockbuster films. This is what we do, right? Before these products can be made available, numerous processes will have taken place and partnerships formed. Imagine what it would be like to live in a country that did not trade with its neighbors. Every day, products would simply not be available. Business would be small because they would not be able to specialize and export their wares overseas. If the standard of living was measured by the variety of products available to consumers, it would be poor, right? If my country is not open to, you know, goods from abroad, obviously the quality, variety of products available to me would be poor, right? Very good, very good. Right, everyone? Very good, Raju. Okay, great communication, greater communication, transportation, and financial flows have shrunk time and distance to create a global economy in recent years. Fine. It is easy to identify global brands that have been around for a long time, such as Coca-Cola, Kodak, Nestle, Ford, and Heinz. Today, international trade is intensifying, right? We are demanding more and more. Our demand see, the demand for the international goods are increasing. All of us want to, you know, use the international, you know, products, right? Whether it's a cosmetic or a shirt. That is a taboo actually these days, right? Status symbol, right, everyone? Companies large and small continuously search for new markets. Okay, consequently, domestic companies in the UK, yeah, are increasingly facing the threat of new competitors. Every day, even I am doing this thing. On Flipkart and everywhere, and even on internet, I am just searching for international brands of cosmetic which are available and I can purchase it in India. This is what I also do, right? There are many differences between trading in the home market and marketing products overseas. Marketing overseas often involves greater risk and detailed understanding of many issues. This I have taught you under international business, right? Currency prices, payments, trading requirements, cultural issues, market structures, and protocols. Trading is not an easy process, and the business requires partnerships to provide them with expertise and support required to compete in the market. Now, no one please, it's a request that don't change the board, don't move it, just read it properly, that's it. From HSBC till competitors, everyone needs to read the same. Someone is again changing it, please don't change it, please don't change it, it's a request. Everyone needs to read it. Asya, Fini, Sunil, Darshana, Prabhavati, Sandeep, Shakir, Rajiv, Shaheen, Ashwin, Kelvin, Ajit, Seher, and Mohammed. I hope you people are reading it. Okay. Prabhavati, we are reading about HSBC Group. That is a bank, right? Hong Kong and Shanghai Bank Corporation. That is the full form. No, what are you? They have stock exchange as well. This is what you are asking. Yeah. Once you are done, tell competitors, just let me know, please. Fine. Is this much? Okay, fine. Now you have to read from there, okay, till market. Please read it so that I can switch over to the next page. Then we are going to do about the benefits of the international trade. Okay. Fine. Everyone, please respond. Don't sit mum. Okay, done. Fine. Let's proceed ahead to the next part. Okay. Now, benefits of international trade. HSBC buying and selling in overseas market offers potential for businesses to develop and expand opportunities. Okay. Some of the key benefits are greater sales volume, which provides the business, which providing the business and trading profitability will translate into higher profits. Okay. An organization ability to compete in several markets can improve through observing the range of trend in quality, product development, design and packing. An organization can improve its reputation with UK customers and boost staff morale. Fine. Existing products and services can be introduced into new markets even they have become less popular in the domestic market. So these are the, you know, advantages of international trade. Okay. The reliance a business has it has on its domestic market can be reduced, and although risks themselves cannot be overcome, they can be spread. For example, if the business does most of its trade in US dollars, it may want to start trading with Japan to spread exchange risk between dollar and yen. Fine. A key element in developing profitable business opportunities is being put in touch with the right people and making the best connection from the outset. Right. So if you want to do trade in India, some company, and if they can, you know, understand the market well, they can get in touch with right people, they can do well as they are doing in domestic market. Specialists at HSBC understand the problems and issues when developing businesses for overseas market. Now, HSBC international trade involves recognizing that people all over the world have different needs, right? So I told you under international business, when we were developing international business, that, you know, what I was telling you, that if you are doing business with another country, you have to keep in mind, what you have to keep in mind, that the culture is different, everything is different, the politics is different, the policies are volatile. So you have to keep in mind all those stuff, and then you have to do business, then you have to plan out things. Okay, then you have to plan for things. Fine. Yeah, many products only to okay were only to okay just a second where I work. Yeah, many products will only suit specific countries due to different values, customs, languages, technical standards and currencies, right? So some, if some product is doing very well, okay, there, like if some product is doing very, very well, you know, in some country, it might not do, it might not be acceptable in another country, right? Right, everyone? Can you give me an example of any such product which is not going to which is going to work very good in well in India, but it is not going to do well abroad? Can you just think of some product? Please think of some product and give me an example in the chat box. Okay, yeah, yes, correct. Okay, there is rarely such a thing as a global market, but rather a number of different overseas markets. In order to pinpoint markets where a business is most likely to be successful in selling its products, a lot of groundwork has to be done and advice sought. It is also just as important to identify the unsuitable market. Yeah, the nature and type of market an organization is considering entering is particularly important. For example, some business might find a small market to be useful, okay, way of slowly expanding into international market, while for others only a large market could provide them with the potential to realize their ambition. Fine. Is this much clear? Okay, can you please read it on your own as well? Then we'll switch over to the next page from buying, okay, till ambition. And don't move the page. Someone is again moving it. Please don't move it. It's a kind request. Please don't do it. Okay, just read it properly and then we go to switch over to the next page. Is everyone done with it? Is everyone done with it? Once you are done, just type done in the chat box, please. Done? Okay, fine. Now, Another factor to consider is the speed at which market is growing. It is usually easier to take a share of an expanding market than to fight for a share of a market that is already mature or declining. So if the market is already mature, it's harder, you know, to find share there. But if the market is still growing, then you can easily get a market for your product as well there itself. Okay? Now, okay, the quality of competition in some markets may make entering these markets difficult. Focusing on countries with fewer competitors might be more beneficial. The degree of similarity to the UK or other markets in which a business operates can also be valuable, as it can be hard for companies to break into markets lacking common ground. Fine. Now, let's switch over to the third part of it. That is secure trading. Okay. Okay. I hope you're not finding it boring. No, I'm asking you. I hope you're not finding it boring. Yes or no? Please let me know. Sunil is saying it's a bit that he is curious. How about others? Rashmi is saying a little bit boring. Okay. See, I haven't designed it. It's like that only. Sometimes it will be interesting. Sometimes you will get boring one. Okay. So please accommodate with me, please, okay? Let's finish it soon, okay? Then we are going to do some interesting one. I'll ask you before switching over to the next. Catering for all these differences can involve greater risk. Some markets may suffer from political and economic instability. In others, distribution channels may make it difficult to get products onto the shelf, right? So see, if I want to, you know, to do international business, sometimes, you know, because of political and economic instability in the market where I want to do my business in the country, I might not be able to do good business, right? Secure business. And also, you know, like distribution channels might not be helping me. So in that case also, you know, it is not going to reach to the customer, irrespective of how hard I am trying. Trading with companies in North America or Europe usually means trading on open account terms, so payment is less certain. In the other parts of the country, documentary credits are more accepted method and provide greater security of payment. Open account. The importer pays for the goods, okay, simply by paying money directly to the exporter after goods has been received. Did you understand what open account is? The importer pays for the goods simply by paying money directly to the exporter after the products have reached him. Okay, he has received the product. This is open account. Importer is paying to the exporter once he has received the goods. Fine? Is it clear? Is it clear? Okay. Documentary credit. An understanding given by the importer bank, okay, to pay a sum of money to the exporter provided the exporter meets certain conditions contained in the documentary credit. Now, HSBC Trade Services. HSBC Trade Services is an important operation within the HSBC group. Supported by electronic delivery, it provides specialist services. Yeah. And tailored solution for customers involved in international trade. HSBC Trade Services provide a partnership role designed to help organization manage the process for effective trading in an increasingly complex trading world, using global reach and local knowledge. Its position of expertise ranks HSBC as one of the largest trade service organizations in the world within an international network of banks. Relationship managers are the gateway to HSBC service for exporters. They provide access to all HSBC services together with the specialist expertise required to develop trade solution that matches the needs of their clients. HSBC has a long established local presence in many countries and territories around the world. With the use of advanced technologies, has a truly global reach. The first stage is often making sure that the right experts in the right countries hears the needs of the business so that connections can be made. Another service is to provide support with document resources. Now, what I'm going to do, rather than continuing with this, I have, you know, very, very short case studies on different, you know, companies. Would you like to do that, like sharing information about them? Should I switch over to that? Please let me know. Because you people are finding it boring. Please let me know. Rabha is saying that's good. How about others? I'll go with the majority. Please let me know fast. Let's not waste time. See, if you are finding something boring, you will never get involved in that. This is my personal belief, so I want to change this. Sandeep is saying everything is okay for him. Okay. So let's switch back to that so that you can learn something from me, and once you will take interest in that, you can even share something with me, right? Even I can gain knowledge from you. Okay, now let's talk about Zara. Zara is a brand. Zara is a global brand of clothing owned by Inditex Group. So you must be wearing, you know, Zara kurtis, females and all, right? Yeah, Sunil, okay. Yeah, it was established in, yeah, Sonam Kapoor is the brand model. Yeah, it was established in 1975 by Spanish fashion designer and tycoon Amancio Ortega. The first store opened in Spain. So the first store of Zara was being opened in Galicia, Spain, where it is now headquartered. So now the headquarters of Zara is at Spain. Okay, the company is very unusual in the fashion retail world and incorporates many pioneering concepts. The company takes just 2 weeks to get its products on its store shelves after designing them. So they'll design it, and within 2 weeks you're going to see it on the store shelf, compared with the 6 months for its competitors. It does not advertise, preferring instead to use money on opening new stores. So they actually save money, okay? They don't, rather than, you know, like doing advertising, they spend the same money in opening new stores in new countries. Okay, Zara also owns and controls every stage of production, from design, manufacture, supply, and sales. So they actually control everything. A Louis Vuitton spokesperson described it as possibly the most innovative and devastating retailers in the world. Zara operates in 70 countries. Do you know that? Okay, now let's switch over to the next part, that is Sony. We haven't covered Sony yet, right? So let's learn about Sony. It's very interesting, the case study on Sony. It's very, very, you know, interesting. So let's do that. Now, everyone knows about Sony. As of now, I'm using the microphone from Sony people, okay? Which I'm using now, it's Sony. Now, Sony Corporation is one of the Japan, so it is from Japan actually. Japan's biggest multinational conglomerate. Okay, it is renowned worldwide for high-tech innovation and quality electronic products, many of which are household names. You must be using Sony hair dryers too, like Sony stereos and so many things, Sony TV, right? It was founded by Akio Morita and Masaru Ibuka in 1946. Yeah, they popularized fridge, I haven't heard of, but yeah, I have a Sony TV at home. They popularized tiny transistors, radios, and gained a solid market in Europe and US. The Sony name was created by combining Sonus, Latin for sonic meaning sound, with Sony, a youthful boy. Sonus and Sony. It was chosen for its simple pronunciation, that is same in any language. So Sony is pronounced as Sony in every language. Okay. Today, Sony is a market leader in batteries, computer games, consoles, cameras, music, and movies and financial services. The Sony Walkman and PlayStation are among their pioneering products. problem was not with my Sony phone. It was with the Indian brand broadband services. That is okay. So it's not best. It's neither cheap nor best. Okay. So the problem was there with the broadband, and it is from BSNL. It is an Indian brand. Okay. Now, is this much clear to everyone? Is this much clear to everyone? Okay, now Manchester United Football Club, you might have heard about it earlier, right? So let's learn about that, okay? I'll try to keep, case studies short. I'll try to keep the short ones so that, it is interesting for you, because if it is too long, you people start losing interest in that. So I won't do very tough ones. Neither I'm going to do long ones. Rather, I will prefer to come up with the case studies which are short and concrete so that you can gain knowledge, right? It's not boring to you. See, I am not here to do time pass. I just don't take classes. It's not like, some teachers, what they do, they'll just keep you, they'll just spend 1 hour like anything. That's it. So I am not of that kind. I just want you to get involved. If you are having any issues, if you're finding something boring, just let me know. I'm going to change it straight away. Because you should get involved. Then only you are going to learn. That is my only motive. Okay? Now, and if you have some suggestions, I'll be take it positively. Okay? Manchester United Football Club is the biggest brand in world football and the world's richest club. Okay? The English Premier League club was founded as Newton Heath in 1878 and changed its name to Manchester United in 1902. It is one of the most successful club in English football and perhaps the most widely supported in the world. Okay? With as many as 350 million fans. So Manchester United Football Club has got 350 million fans. In 2010, Forbes magazine ranked Manchester United second to the New York Yankees in its list of the world's most valuable sports team brands. The club has always managed to secure lucrative sponsorship deals and regularly receives the highest share of TV rights. United manage its worldwide exposure well through its own TV channel, MUTV. It also has financial services arm and foundation to help poor children succeed. So this is all about Manchester United. Now, I have got information about this NBA. Do you know what NBA is? Does anyone know what NBA is? What do they sell? NBA, what is that? See, National Basketball Association. Many of you doesn't know about it. So eBay, you must be doing shopping from eBay, everyone, right? I do a lot of shopping from eBay. So let's learn about eBay. Yeah, it's a basketball club. So what are things you people do shopping on eBay? Okay. So what are the products they sell? eBay. What are the products they sell? They sell everything, dresses, cosmetics, everything. I do purchase, cosmetics and decorative items from there. Okay, this is what I purchase. Now, eBay Inc. is the world's largest e-commerce company. It was founded as an online auction site in 1905 called AuctionWeb by Piri Omerjian. Okay. Okay, so you might have purchased sunglasses from there, right? I actually choose a particular brand sunglasses. Even I love wine sunglasses, but I am crazy about a particular brand, so I buy sunglasses from there only. Okay. Now he said, you can just imagine, you can just guess the name. Obviously Ray-Ban. Ray-Ban, correct. Now, he said what I wanted to do was to create an efficient market where regular people could compete with big business. It was a little bit of an experiment. He changed the name in 97 to be similar to his company, Echo Bay Technology Group. Within 2 years of starting, the company hosted how many auctions? 20 lakhs auctions. Okay? The company's website explains the success story to date. with more than 90 million active users globally, eBay is the world's largest online marketplace. You can even get second-hand products here. You know that? Auction, on auction, and you can even get products on auction here. Yeah, that's correct. Okay? You can even sell products, yeah. eBay is the world's largest online marketplace where practically anyone can buy and sell practically anything. In 2009, the total worth of goods sold on eBay was $60 billion to $2,000 every second. The company employs over 15,000 people throughout the world. Fine? Is it clear, everyone? Is it first clear? So should I will try to cover, you know, very short case studies rather than going for very, very long ones. Okay? So that you can enjoy it. You can learn from it. Okay? Now, let's learn about another. Okay? Rolex. What does Rolex people sell? Please tell me. Watches, correct. They do sell watches. Now, so Rolex is one of the famous brands of high quality luxury watches. They don't sell watches, they sell luxury watches. They are widely regarded as a status symbol. The company was started by Hans Wildorf and his brother-in-law Alfred Davis in London in 1905. So they are as old as 1905, you can imagine. They registered the name Rolex in 1908. In 1990, the company moved to Geneva, Switzerland, where it has stayed ever since. Rolex has been pioneer in watchmaking and produced the first ever self-winding watch. Okay, the first watch with an automatically changing date and first underwater timepiece. Do you know that they made the first underwater timepiece? What is underwater timepiece? What does underwater timepiece mean? What is that? So it is going to work well in water as well. Okay? Water resistant clock. Yeah. Okay? Today the company produces over 2,000 watches a day, all put together by highly skilled workers. Okay? The company has never-ending job of pursuing counterfeits of its products. Rolex generates around $3 billion in annual revenues and employs just less than 3,000 staff. The staff is quite less, but they generate a lot of revenue. Do you know that? Okay, fine. Yeah. Okay. Now. Is this much clear to everyone? Any questions for me so far? Any questions? Pringles. What does Pringle people sell? Pringles. Chips. Correct. Potato chips. Yeah. So do you know about Pringles? See, when it comes to Pringle people, that is produced by P&G, that is Procter & Gamble. Pringles is a brand of potato and wheat snack produced by P&G. It is one of the world's most recognized and best-selling snacks. Do you know that? So Procter & Gamble people, you know, produce Pringles. Pringles came into the market in 1968. The name Pringles came from an employee opening a telephone directory and seeing the name Pringle Drive in it. They are sold in over 100 countries and generate revenue in excess of $1 billion. Pringles cannot be called potato chips or potato crisps for legal reasons because each Pringle contains only 42% potato. Okay? So it is a picture of potato and wheat. So you just cannot call them potato chips. Okay? And they are popular because of the diversity of the flavors, uniform paddle shape, okay, called a hyperbolic paraboloid, right? They have a specific shape and the container that keeps them in one piece. The cremated remains of the inventor of the cylinder can be buried in Pringles can at his request. The Pringles slogan is, once you pop, the fun does not, don't stop, right? So once you pop, the fun do not stop is the slogan associated with that, right? Okay. Is this what's here? Is this what's clear? Any questions so far? Okay, so we are done for today. Now for tomorrow, we are going to learn the slogans of different companies. Okay? It's very important for us to know the slogans of different companies. Okay, so we are going to learn that in tomorrow's class, followed by the topic which we were doing today. Okay, Dil Maange More. Okay, correct. Okay, so it will be a fun. What is your view about it? Should we do that tomorrow? The slogans of different companies. Like the Amul is the like the taste of India. Rasna is like I love you, Rasna, right? Thanda matlab Coca-Cola, right? So tomorrow we're going to learn that. Okay. Thank you so much for today. See you tomorrow. Please be there. Please be on time. Okay. Thank you so much. And I'm also going to cover the topic which we were doing today. And don't forget to fill the feedback form. Take care. Bye. Thank you so much.